demo of SugarPoke, the first augmented reality app for public health. And if you do not have it yet on your phone, and you wonder why would I ever poke sugar and know how much sugar there is in my food, then please download it immediately. You can go to the App Store, Google Play, put it on your phone as we speak, and you can also text SugarPoke to 444999 right now, which will give you all our contact information, including access to the app and more. And you wonder why do we care about sugar so much? Well, here's a chart. I know it's a little difficult to read because there's 35 countries. There's the OECD list of countries and the latest statistics released just a week ago of obesity among adults. You see from Japan with 3.7%, Korea 5%, and then average is 19, the red bar, and then the US is at 38.2%. It's a record, it keeps going up, and that does not even include overweight population, which is another third of the population. And the main reason is the sugar hidden in our food. Hidden where? Not where you would expect, not just beverages and sweets. Half of it is hidden in savory foods. It's in everything. So I will give you one example, the demo I'm making today, of SugarPoke, an app we invented to disclose how much sugar there is in a language you understand, how many teaspoons of sugar, and I will demo it on salad dressings. The demo you're downloading right now on your phone will allow you to test it at home, so you can try for yourself. But let me try it, and I'll plug it in. Can you see it?
Yep.
Okay, 12 teaspoons of added sugar in this bottle. You want to try cold stone? This is 16. And as I go down the aisle and I look for one that may have no added sugar, it's a challenge. Because most of them do. I'll say 99%. Actually, out of 500, we found only two that had no added sugar. And there's only two colors possible in our world. Black, how many teaspoons? In like 32 teaspoons of added sugar. Do you have that in your fridge? Let me think again. Okay, try this one. 44 teaspoons of added sugar. Okay, and you wonder why? You read the label. For those who know how to read labels, most people don't, but you'll find out first ingredient, high fructose corn syrup or sugar. And then finally, you look for this one. Zero, green label. So it's all about green and black. And you have to make the healthy choices. As we move down, I'm going to go back to the presentation. Can it move forward or it needs to be plugged in? Okay, we'll switch back. Okay, so you've seen this and that, and you wonder why? Again, why do we focus on sugar? Because we found that the US population puts more sugar in their salads than they do in their coffee. You look at numbers and you think, well, it's only 3% of added sugar is used in sauces and dressing. That's not much, right? Think again. It's 680 million pounds of sugar per year in those little bottles. It does include ketchup, yes. And of course, the solution is what you all do, you do it yourself. I make mine with a touch of mustard, the French touch. But more seriously, what do we need to do is to really encourage kids and adults to poke through the glass at the vending machine and to develop a tool that will allow you to disclose how much sugar in those snacks before you press that button so that you know, actually. So what we're doing now, first of all, thank you for having us, but what we're doing that's really extraordinary is we have 14 volunteers for the summer that worked really hard at the foundation. We're a 501c3. And we're raising $40,000 to make this real and to scale it up to the entire supermarket and food system in the US, covering 100,000 SKUs. And that's quite possible because we've done it before for another app with Chris and his team. And we were able to create the database and scale up and cover the entire market. So thank you all for helping us, if you want, and I'll answer some questions. Yes, please.
Two very quick questions. One, are you only counting artificially added sugars or also naturally occurring carbohydrates that aren't fiber? And question two, how are you collecting the data on how much sugar there is? Because some labels are notoriously misleading or just straight off incorrect.
Thank you for the two great questions. So the first question is, are we counting natural sugars? I call them primary sugars, the natural sugars that's in the pulp of that fruit. No, we're not counting that. We're counting the added sugar, the one that's hidden and added, I call the secondary sugar. I did the last TED talk I did on this topic, if you Google it, is secondary sugar kills. And it explains it very well, and it explains the addiction to sugar that starts as a little kid, as a baby and then a toddler. The second question is, how do we gather data? Our team of volunteers has been writing to those companies. We've been writing to 50 companies making salad dressing. We've been writing to companies making health bars, yogurts, all these quote-unquote healthy products to ask them, please, how much added sugar do you have in your product? Given that the FDA makes it mandatory to disclose for July next year until the new administration put a hold on this. But the manufacturers know how much added sugar they put in their food. Another question? Yes, please. Sorry, go ahead. So the question on serving size, let me clarify that we do not use serving size because we find it to be completely deceiving. It's way too little, and I worked in the food industry for 20 years, so I had to play the game, and you just minimize the serving size to have low numbers. Instead, what we do and what you've seen on these labels is the entire product, which will allow also consumers to realize when they pick a bottle that that Coke has 10 teaspoons of sugar, but that bigger one has 60. You have a question, please. So the question is, do we have plans to expand to other products such as ketchup, and are we going to cover trans fats? So I'll start with trans fats, no. We've decided to focus on sugar as the culprit and the main problem in our diet. And if you go back to these and you try it for yourself at home, you'll find out at the supermarket, in those 15 products we have in the demo, you will find out that the fat-free is the one that is the worst offender, has more sugar. 3 times more, most often. So do we plan to expand? Yes, that's why I'm here today. We are looking for a partner, a funder, somebody who believes in this cause and will help us scale it up. And with that budget of $40,000, we'll be able to expand to the entire foodscape in the US, 100,000 products, every product category. Within about 8 months, we figured it would take to make it. Any other questions? Yes, gentlemen in back.
One more. You thought about the protection, talking about other sugars, not necessarily defined carbohydrates.
Do we want to cover other sugars, not just refined sugars? Again, the way we've classified them is between the primary or the naturally occurring sugars and the added sugars. However, they go under 61, maybe 62 different names in the industry. Most of the times, people don't realize it is sugar. And there's another industry practice that's rampant, which is to break down the number of different sugars you use in a box of cereal, say. You will have maltodextrin, in addition to brown rice syrup and other kind of sugars, so that they don't appear to be number one on the package, when in fact, the largest ingredient has to appear first on the list, so it's another trick the industry plays. So again, we're very focused on processed sugar, where we think the main problem is in our diet and in our health system today. Thank you all.